To mark St. George's Day, Seth Lakeman takes us on a musical journey from Devon to the heart of the Midlands.
But for me, it's more... I've been quite lucky so far. TV and radio stations have helped me bring my music into the mainstream. But now I want to go one step further, working with a completely new set of musicians from the streets of inner city Birmingham, and they've invited me to jam with them and see if we can create a whole new sound. I want to see if I can fuse the music of the countryside with the music of the streets, urban hip-hop, like no one's ever heard it before. I'm slightly unsure how it's going to work, working with Moorish Delta 7, but I think curiosity as a musician and a songwriter has really got the better of me. You can't get further away from folk music and hip-hop. They're different worlds.
I spent a lot of time up here and on other tours in other areas of Dartmoor, really kind of drawing inspiration from the whole area and the isolation and the dramatic kind of environment that Dartmoor is. The part of Moors that I come from, it really kind of affects the style of the music I'm writing. It feels very organic and very much a part of Dartmoor.
Here lies the grave of Kitty J. This is a young servant girl who committed suicide. And she hung herself because she became pregnant by a young landowner. So she was buried here on unconsecrated ground. And the story goes, and legend goes, that every morning flowers are laid here by an unknown hand, and that is the mystery of Kitty J.
Poor Kitty J. She's such a beauty cast away. This silent prayer, she brings some peace on her grave. Something broke her sleep.
I'm from Dartmoor, southwest Devon, and I've lived here and been brought up here in my life. I think my mother said when I was about 5 years old, I said I really wanted to play the violin. So she bought me one of those quarter-sized violins. And I got to about grade four, I started to really get excited with Scottish, English and Irish folk tunes. This is quite interesting, actually. This is a guitar, actually, someone made for me, a guy called Stuart Ketchin. It's a guitar made of Hawaiian koa wood. Beautiful guitar, though. It's amazing. So we use that when we're in the studio. But this is my record collection. There's a few LPs, especially some folky ones here, of guys like Jonathan Kelly. It's an amazing record, that one, actually. This is quite a funny one. That's quite good, isn't it? The World of the Countryside. Great designs. It's amazing. It's like looking out your back door, isn't it? Hip-hop? No, there isn't any hip-hop. Return of the Jedi. Obviously in everyone's collection, this record. Return of the Jedi. This is a selection of bows that I've used in the past few months on gigs. I'm quite ferocious when I play the violin. As you can see, all the horsehair disintegrates in the shows that I'm doing. I go through bow every two or three shows, I think. So what I do in songwriting, if I'm writing with the tenor guitar, is I would work out a tune that would be hooky enough that people remember, and then I would try and kind of establish some lyrics or a story over the top. So I mean, So I bought this the other day. Well, I'll say I've had it for years, shall I? I've had this for years. This is an amazing gramophone, hang on. All working. I love the way the iPod is sat next to it. That's genius. So let's wind it up. Let's see what we've got on today then. Okay, it's original. Here we go.
Yeah.
I'm slightly unsure working with Moorish Delta 7, and I'm kind of wondering why the hell I'm doing this.
Body attribute, animal instinct, big man, scythe, jewels, black panther.
So I make a good percentage of the beats for MD7. I'm also one of the MCs, so I write and perform on the tracks and perform live with the group.
Yeah, my name's Jawar. I'm from BC, Birmingham City, part of Moorish Delta Underworld fam.
I don't know how my, regular MD7 fans would kind of see or take to it. So, you know what I mean? That there's the challenge right there. Then, you know what I mean? There will be a loss of credibility. And, you know what I mean? Moorish Delta's name, we can't go through that.
I feel so good.
It feels good, that's street love. I try to give it back in words. Back against the wall, now I'm back in first. Back off my coat, back on my turf, back on my post.
Sex in the city, ho. She on the greasy deli, try to be in video.
Give me respect, I respect you. You disrespect me and test me. I disrespect and test you too.
Oh, Kevin, you don't catch her. Oh, give her right of way. For she will look upon you.
It was very musical growing up because my parents both played, so and both my brothers do as well. My brother Sam plays the piano and he's a producer. My oldest brother Sean plays the guitar. We still work together now, and so every now and again we get together and play in local pubs.
Hang on, what did that?
Hang on. 1, 2, 3, 4.
I know I find the rest. I've shot my own true love like the bird upon her nest. Like lead in my heart lies the deed that I have done.
We had a pretty full childhood making dens and playing boy things, you know, getting very dirty and very, I nailed him to a tree once, making a tree house. He's actually quite shy and retiring. He'll go along with things to try and sometimes it doesn't necessarily have the best outcome. Well, I think it might be a bit of a lion's den for him. He's more used to hanging out in rural towns and rural pubs and not necessarily hanging in the hood. So, worst case scenario, he knows how to barricade himself into a safe room, so if he needs to do that for whatever reason, then he's got the skills. I've seen him do it before.
The Moorish Soldier.
So we're heading up north to Birmingham, and we're gonna go and meet for the first time. I'm going to meet MD7, Moorish Delta 7. It's definitely, I woke up this morning and I think it's the reality of actually going to their environment and going to Birmingham, which really, it's really hit home. And I think, yeah, it certainly made me more nervous than I certainly was before.
But across the street, cause Cypher is the wrong one.
The worst that can happen,
I don't think I can necessarily lose anything. Or can I? I don't know. What can I lose? You need to tell me.
If I can lose anything, I'm buggering off, mate.
a certain amount of worries because of, I guess, how it's going to emerge with Moorish Delta 7.
Hi, guys.
Hey.
How you doing?
What's cracking?
It's good to meet you, man. You all right?
Good to meet you, sir.
You all right?
Cypher,
good to meet you. You're up, good to meet you.
Yeah.
You good, man? You all right?
Yeah,
yeah.
That's
how
we do it.
Okay, cool.
Yeah,
go on, man.
Looking forward to doing some stuff, bro.
Yeah, this is going to be quite funny, I think.
Yeah, man, I think it is, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, it's just, if you don't try this sort of stuff, do you? You never know, do you?
No, but how can you create experimentation? Yeah, experimentation, man.
Yeah, definitely. It's cool, man.
So what's first?
Yeah, man, I'm
Talk
about the place, man.
Can I have a pee first?
Yeah, man.
How many keys you got? But if you were in a rush, right?
Yeah.
You had to get in there, fire. Yeah. What would you do? Have you got a Sally key? Where's your car key? Oh, well, that's easy. But the wheels all look the same, don't they?
Yeah, but they got different notches, man.
Yeah, I know that. But, I mean,
just memorise the notches, innit? You look like a hip hopper, you know, bro. I'm just saying, you know, yeah, you don't. You know, you don't look like you're in the Pogues or anything like that. You get what I'm saying?
Well, that's good.
Stay on my level, cunt. Talk these levels, girls. Love them levels. How we get illegal dope? Stay on my level, cunt. Talk these levels, girls. Love them levels. How we get illegal dope?
So basically, this block. This is the block I lived in, ninth floor.
This is it, yeah?
Martin Tower. Joao lived on the third floor of that block.
Yeah.
And then Malik, where them blocks are over there, across the road. Malik lived across the road. So we was just like...
We're sort of hanging out together.
Do you know what I'm saying? You know, I remember like making tunes, making beats, waking up about 2 o'clock in the morning, calling Malik, like, yo, Malik, I made this beat, man. The beat's just wicked. Like, I'm gonna play down the phone.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, yeah, this is Newtown. First video was done here, Out of Survival, where we had about 30 people, thugs, like the whole crew, you know, we had like a whole getaway scene where I would run into a car. That was our first video on the ends.
Yeah.
And we just wanted to show it, like, us in our own environment.
Yeah.
Sergi, safe.
Well, that's cool, man.
So we've done a next video called, Silent Screams.
Yeah.
And a part of that was shot in the park, just there, Yellow Park. To live life clean, please listen to my silent scream. Wrap it in cellophane, sell it to a fiend. Get the green, hear my silent scream. This is the foundation of like of you know, hip hop production. This is what hip hop production was all about. And you create things with keyboards and drum machines. And this is still the foundation of, you know, classic hip hop records. It was all about, you know, what samples are you using and what that have never been used before. So like this shop is, this groove for me is like the, was always the best shop to get breakbeats in. You know what I mean? And as you can see, it's every form of music you can think of.
Yeah, it's amazing.
I remember coming in here in the early days, like, you know what I mean, you know, with ladies, you know what I'm saying, and they just couldn't take it, you know what I mean? Because an hour is like just not enough
bored.
Time.
Okay. Come on.
Yeah, obviously I'm there. I've got a pile and I'm playing through, you know, records and I'm perfectly content to just, you know what I mean, play the record of each one by one. And ooh.
So you can pick one of them and obviously you can play it and then you'll listen to it and see if you fancy it and then...
Yeah, like, I even show you, like, can I, you still got the record player in the corner?
Yeah, you can use this one if you want.
Oh, sorry. Right, these records, like, man, I get passionate about them. So imagine I put a drum beat on that.
Ah.
This used to be a popular pub.
Did it?
Yeah.
Is it closed down then?
Yeah.
How come it closed down?
Various reasons still. And then
what reasons?
It's various. And then that shop there.
Yeah.
That was another bookshop. Used to be an old man, used to sell a lot of books. That's a lot, you know, when we were kids, and I remember, like, this used to be an Aldi superstore, and at the front of the shop, they used to sell books and stuff like that. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So a lot of even the reading, a lot of me getting into reading and stuff like that was because they used to sell books on the strip there.
Right.
It's good to feel, you know, to be part of a community. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You got family.
Yeah.
You've got communities,
yeah,
and then you've got nations, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And it's like,
Cypher, he's great. Amazing guy, and he's very creative, you can tell. I feel quite privileged to be taken into his kind of environment. So he's quite a big guy. I mean, I'm quite short, as most people know. I'm getting sort of neck ache now. I just wouldn't get into a fight with a guy. Definitely not. I don't think I'd win. Malik, he's obviously a very talented hip-hop artist, rapper, wordsmith, and freestyler, so, you know, I'm really looking forward to working with him as well.
First, we take him to the doctors in Grove Lane, the dentist in Grove Lane, so we can get some gold teeth, you get what I'm saying? We're going to fix him up some clothes, get him a little bit of jewellery, you know what I mean? A little something around the wrist, you know what I mean? I think he'll be ready. What do you think, sir? Eh? Where do you want him? On the bottom or the top?
Top.
Jawa is great, yeah, he's a really lovely guy.
Yeah, it's lovely, it's, you get what I'm saying? Bam!
Yeah, yeah.
That's how we greet each other up here, isn't it? Yeah.
I was obviously really nervous before meeting them, but, you know, they've shown me around their hometown and, you know, they couldn't have been more accommodating. It's been a great first start. Come back to we're from different parts of the country, you know, and some people would say, you know, completely different worlds, but I think there's a big similarity in the way that we want to express ourselves with music. And we got...
Lay the violin first.
Yeah.
And then lay the vocals, innit?
Okay, yeah.
Let's just stick it on there, innit? And... I'll just go up against that mic.
I would say there is a pressure to create the best music that we can create together.
Can you hear, bro?
Yeah.
Ready?
Yeah. Shit, I didn't come in. Should we...
Basically, Seth put down a basic beat and Seth came up with the melody. Everybody was feeling it, we laid that down.
You rock, man!
In terms of filling the venue, I think, hopefully, you know, it's been a short space of time, but I think, you know, there's been a bit of publicity about it. Who knows, really? I mean, what are people doing on a Thursday night? Maybe they'll... drop Holby City in Coronation Street and head down, who knows?
Slightly worried about the publicity because we haven't really had long at all really to like publicise the event and let people know what's going on. Yeah, man.
Chip, chip. Malik MD7, Underworld Family, Seth Lakeman. Let's go. All I know for certain, this is a cloudy day. And I'm just so searching, just... Come here one more time.
That's proper. Enough,
and then do we want to do this? Because Joel was not sure.
What was the last line before?
Would the music be with guys?
Before that.
Not before that.
And throw your hands into a blood red sky.
Throw your hands into... Really, you said that.
Love will find a way like strippers find a yay. Like night follows day, that's how I pursue my pay. Life's in shades of grey. Respect what? What's in shades of grey?
I guess, you know, we'll be here till quite late. It's a great city, yeah. It seems really friendly. And so far, you know, wandering around the streets, it's very different to Dartmoor, obviously, which is where I'm from. But I think you can very easily gain inspiration from this whole area, you know. So I can see why the guys in MD7, you know, are writing such powerful music.
Because of music, we've been brought together, and look what we've come out with. It shows you that regardless to race, creed, culture, religion, geography, that people essentially are people. You get what I'm saying?
I know people of different nationalities and whatnot because of music, especially in the streets where people don't really just, if they don't know a person, they ain't going up to them and start a conversation. But music is the icebreaker that, you know what I mean? A man could say a certain thing and, you know what I mean, a conversation can kick off. So with Seth and doing this music together, you know what I mean? It's all love. It's all love.
The lyrics are expressing what we feel about music and how passionate we are about that. And the way I think the two cultures have come together, the way our backgrounds and our genres have come together. I reckon it's going to be called Find Your Way, I reckon. And yeah, it's pretty cool. I feel very prepared for tonight, I think. We just need to fill the venue, really. And that's the worry, because there's only been a few days, really, to promote this thing, but it's tense.
Do you do anything before you go on stage, guys? Like, getting ready?
Have a hug. You need to sort of put one hand
on. Do you hear that?
Want to say a few words, and then, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and then we'll go on.
Drink a little whiskey.
I have a double blended.
All I want is a bottle of water.
Just the fact that there will be different crowds there, different listeners, and those two peoples will be coming together. That in itself is a success.
We're just here supporting some of my homeboys, you know.
We're here because my flatmates told me that he's quite fit.
We've got one person hopefully is going to enjoy the gig tonight.
I'll be enthusiastic, don't worry.
I mean, there's loads of things in folk music that are really dark and violent, and I think that comes through in a lot of what I've heard of hip hop.
Seemingly opposite sides of the music scene coming together just for a gimmick. That's the worst possible thing that could happen, where hip hop is brought to a mainstream audience and then just plunge into the abyss again.
This is one of these ones that you'd never kind of expect, because I think that Moorish is so in their world. Do you understand what I'm saying? That it's kind of, for them to collaborate with like a folk artist is just kind of, it's crazy, like the polar opposites.
I don't expect him to come out in a tractor or anything like that. You know what I'm saying, with a cowboy hat and straw coming out of his mouth. But, you know what I mean, all I expect is him to play good music, you know.
The people's always the final judge when it comes to music, you know, whether they feel it or not, and I'm confident that they will feel it.
I'd like to welcome on the stage the great MD7, Moorish Delta 7. Come on, guys.
Certain, this is a cloudy day. So searching, trying to find my way. I went to bed so late, but now I'm wide awake. Creative mind state, call it the great escape. My experiences, I hope that you can relate. Let me show you how two different cultures can integrate and bring you something new. I hope that you agree. It's original music, rediscovery.
So listen, the way you stand in life. Choices either wrong or right. Follow me and I will be your guide, and you will find your way.
Lost, I needed direction. Streets had me depressed, struck with frustration. Then I came up turntables and a mic. You saved yourself, your music is a spark of life. Yeah, so majestic, I have to get my point across. To everybody's ears, your soul and your heart. Yeah, we gotta meet in our minds, gotta seize the time. You seek your wine, so meet me on the borderline.
Tell me about the way you stand in life.
Yeah.
Make your choices, I'll be wrong or right.
Yeah.
Follow me and I will be your guide. And you will find your way. Choices out there, wrong, go right.
Yeah.
Follow me and I will be your guide. And you will find your way.
You will find your way.
Love will find a way and the strippers find a yay. Like day follows day, that's how I pursue my pay. My life's in shades of grey. Pursue what my heart say, but feel it with my Tommy Grant. So I'm going more great. It's violence and spoke, hip hop and folk. It's music from the zones you don't provoke. It's real. And it can't all be filled, so let the music
be your guide. Tell me about the way you stand in life.
Yeah.
You make your choices, are you wrong or right?
Yeah.
Follow me and I will be your guide.
Yeah.
And you will find your way.
You will find your way.
Tell me about the way you stand in life.
Yeah.
You make your choices, are you wrong or right? Choices, are you wrong or right?
Yeah.
Follow me and I will be your guide. You will find your way.
You will find your way.
Tell me about the way you stand in life.
Yeah.
Make your choices, are you wrong or right?
Yeah.
Follow me and I will be your guide. And you will find your way.
You will find your way.
It's been an honor.
I think that proves it can work, right?
It went down perfectly, you know what I mean? People heard all the lyrics, felt all the lyrics.
All I can say is my man does some mean, plays the mean fiddle, you know?
Oh, it was amazing. I couldn't have gone any better. Absolutely brilliant. These guys are awesome, man. Absolutely great. Honestly, it's a privilege. Absolutely brilliant.
So go ask people in the crowd, but go ask people.
I'm hoarse right now. Just from shouting appreciation. So to me, like-minded people coming together to make good, honest, emotional music is success on all levels. So hopefully it could just escalate.
The collaboration was really, really clever, and I didn't think it would work that well, to be honest. It was really good.
I thought what came out today was real, man, and you felt the energy back from the crowd. It was nice, man. I appreciated everything that happened tonight, man. It was nice.
The two contrasts, sort of heavy hip-hop beat and then that sort of nice, you know, emotional singing on top, just the contrast is perfect.
The folk music is about people, hip-hop's about people, so it's the same music, so it sounds different, you know what I mean, it sounds different but it's the same integrity, so like I say, it's a beautiful thing, serious.
But I mean, this whole experience has really shown me how similar these two genres are, hip-hop and folk, and how they can really connect with the people and we can all become a part of that. So this has been an amazing project for me, and I think people should open their minds to all sorts of genres of music. I know I'm going to.
Follow me and I will be your guide, and you will find your way.
You will find your way.
Tell me by the way you stand in.
To hear more music from Seth Lakeman and MD7, and to see how other artists have been inspired by England, log on to bbc.co.uk/made in England.
Tell me about the way you stand in life.
Oh.
Make your choices, are you wrong or right?
Yeah.
Follow me and I will be your guide. And you will find your way.
And you will find your way.